When any law provides any kind of documents or any kind of records or the information, that record or document or the information should be kept safely and it should be retained for the specific period of time. NEGP stands for National E-Governance Plan. Hi and a warm welcome to you all, dear students. I, George Elmay, Commerce Faculty, Department of Commerce, Vidyashram First Grade College, the Temple of Excellence, Mysuru. Dear students, today we shall take up session 4 of Unit 5, that is of Information Technology Act 2000. So in the last class, I was explaining to you students about the various important terms in this particular unit. Now, continuing with that, we shall move on to the next term, that is of e-governance. What do you mean by e-governance? E-governance or electronic governance is dealt under the section 4 to 10A. Of the IT Act, that is Information Technology Act of 2000, and it says it provides for legal recognition of electronic records. So this particular e-governance or electronic governance, it will provide the legal recognition, or it gives legal recognition for the electronic records and electronic signature, and also it provides the legal recognition for of contracts which has been formed through electronic means. So, the purpose of e-governance or electronic governance is it will provide legal recognition of electronic records as well as electronic signatures. It gives recognition, legal recognition for electronic signatures, and also it provides the legal recognition for the contracts which has been done or made under the electronic means or modes or methods. Now, filing of this any form, application or any other documents, creation, retention or preservation of these records, which is coming under e-governance, or issue of grant or any licenses or permit or receipt or payment, that is in government offices and its agencies, may be done through the means of electronic form. So, filing of any form under this e-governance or applications or any other documents, then creation of a document, retention or preservation of the records or the documents, then issue or grant of any kind of license or permit or the receipt or the payments in the government offices, made in the government offices and in its agencies, may be done through the means of electronic form. Now, the government may authorize any of their service providers to set up, maintain as well as to upgrade the computerized facilities and also perform any other such services as it may specify, that is by notification in the official gazette, that is for efficient delivery of the services to the public through electronic means. So the government, what they do, they may authorize any of the service provider to set up then to maintain and to upgrade the computerized facilities which are there in the office, government offices, in order to perform such other services as it may specify, and that is by giving a notification in the official gazette and for efficient delivery of the services to the public, so that through this electronic means. Now, the service provider who has been authorized, so authorized includes any individual. Now, who is the service provider? The service provider who has been authorized by the government or its agencies to provide any of the services to the public, they may be of any individual, or they may be a private agencies, or they may be private company, or it may be a partnership firm, or it may be a sole proprietor, right? Sole proprietorship, or any other bodies or agencies, right, which has been granted permission from the government or by the appropriate government agencies in order to offer these kind of services through electronic means and in accordance with the government, that is in accordance with the policies which is governing such service sectors. And students, it says where any law provides the documents, records or the any other information, it should be retained for a specific period. So, when any law provides any kind of documents or any kind of records or the information, that record or document or the information should be kept safely and it should be retained for the specific period of time. So, then such documents, records or that information retained in electronic form will be covered, and if the information contained therein remains accessible, then the electronic record is retained in the format in which it was originally generated or sent or received in the format which can be demonstrated or in order to represent, that is the accurately the information in original format or in the original generated which has been sent or received, and the details which will facilitate the identification of the origin, destination, date and time of dispatch or the receipt of such kind of electronic records which are available in the electronic record. Now it says where any law provides for audit of documents, that is that for the checking of the documents, records or any other information or information, then that provision will also be applicable for audit of documents, records or information processed and maintained in the electronic form. So likewise, where any law provides that rule, regulation, order, then bylaws, notification or any other matter, it should be published in the official gazette, and then such kind of requirement shall be deemed to have been satisfied if that particular rule or such rule or regulation or order or bylaw or notification or any other matter, it is been published and in the official gazette or in the electronic gazette. But however, the above mentioned provisions does not give any right to anybody to compel any ministry or the department of government to use this electronic means, that is to accept it, to issue, create, retain and preserve any document or execute any monetary transaction. Even though all that provisions which are mentioned above, it does not give any right to anybody to compel any ministry, or that means to compel means to force or to compel any ministry or department of government to use electronic means to accept, issue, create, retain and preserve any document or execute any kind of monetary transaction, that is any kind of monetary means the money related matters or transaction. Now there are some following e-governance applications already using the digital signatures. So here MCA 21, that means it is a mission model project under NEGP, that is National E-Governance Plan. So NEGP stands for National E-Governance Plan, which is one of the first few e-governance projects which is coming under the NEP, that is National E-Governance Plan, and to successfully implement the digital signatures in that project. Second is income tax e-filing. Now you can see that now all are done, all the income tax has been done through e-filing, there is no manual. Then Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation, IRCTC, it is also done through this electronic mode. Then Director of General of Foreign Trade. Then RBI applications, that is Structured Financial Messaging System. Then National E-Governance Service Delivery Gateway. Then we have e-procurement, that is any purchasing through electronic modes or e-office. All the documents taking into consideration into this particular e-office, then e-district application of UP, Assam, etc. Now students, coming to the next important aspect related to this is known as certifying authorities. Who are the certifying authorities and what are their duties and what are their functions? A certifying authority is a trusted body. It is a trusted body, it says, whose central responsibility is to issue, revoke, renew and provide directories of digital certificates. So a certifying authority is a trusted body first and foremost. Secondly, they have a central responsibility, that is to issue, revoke, stop, renew, continue and provide the directories of digital certificates. So certifying authority means a person who has been granted a license. So certifying authority means he is an individual or a person who has been granted a license in order to issue an electronic signature certificate under section 24. Now it contains detailed provisions which is related to the appointment and powers of the controller and the certifying authorities. Now the controller of certifying authorities, CCA we say. Now, the IT Act, that is Information Technology Act, provides for the controller of the certifying authorities to license and to regulate the working of certifying authorities. So, this IT Act provides that particular person known as a controller of certifying authorities to issue the license and regulate and tell them how to or how to function or how to do the work regarding the working of certifying authorities. The certifying authorities issues digital signature certificates for electronic authentication of the users. Now, this certifying authorities, they'll be issuing what? The digital certificate, that is digital signature certificate. Digital signature certificates, that is for electronic authentication of users. Now, the certifying authorities, the control of certifying authorities certifies the public keys of the controller or certifying authorities using its own private key, which will enable the users in the cyberspace to verify that a given certificate is issued by a licensed controller or certifying authority or not. So, I'll repeat, control of certifying authority certifies, they will certify, they say that, certifies that the public keys of the certifying authorities using its own private keys, which enables the users in the cyberspace, that is to check or verify that particular certificate which is being given by the CA issued by the certified authority. Now, for this purpose, it operates the Root Certifying Authority of India, in short form we call as RCAI, that is the Root Certifying Authority of India, and the CCA also maintains the National Repository of Digital Certificates, that is NRDC, National Repository Digital Certificates, which contains all the certificates issued by all the CAs in the country, that is certifying authorities in the country. Now, what are the functions of this controller, control of certifying authority? The first and foremost function is they have to exercise the supervision, they have to supervise over the activities of the certifying authorities. They need to supervise the work or the functions which has been carried out by the certifying authorities. Secondly, they need to certify the public keys of the certifying authorities. Third, it says lays down the standards to be maintained by the certifying authorities. And fourth, it specifies the qualification and the experience which the employees of certifying authorities should possess. So, what are the qualification, what are the experience that particular certifying authority should have to become a certifying authority? Then it will specify the conditions subject to which the certifying authorities shall conduct their business. And it specifies the content of writing, printed or visual material and advertisements that may be distributed or used in respect of electronic signatures, certificate and the public key. Next functions is specifying the form of content of electronic signature, certificate and the key. Then specify the form and manner in which the account shall be maintained by the certifying authorities, that is what, in which manner and how should be account should be maintained in their office. Then it specifies the terms and conditions subject to which the auditors may be appointed and the remuneration which is being paid to them. They facilitate the establishment of any electronic system by certifying authority, either solely or jointly, that is singly or in together with one or two with other certifying authorities, and regulation of systems. Then it says next point, that is specify the manner in which the certifying authorities shall conduct their dealings with the subscribers. Now, and in that it says resolve any kind of conflict, that means solve the fights or the conflicts of interest between the certifying authorities and the subscribers. If there are any kind of fights between or conflicts takes place, then they will look into to solve that particular matter or the problem which arises between the certifying authorities and the subscribers. Then it lays down the duties of the certifying authorities. Then maintains the database containing the disclosure of record of every certifying authorities containing such particulars as may be specified by the regulation, which shall be accessible to the public. And the controller has a power to grant recognition to the foreign certifying authorities with the previous approval of the central government. So, this certifying authority or the CCA, we say control of certifying authority. So, he has a power to grant recognition to the foreign certifying authorities, that is with the previous approval by the central government, which will be subject to such conditions and restrictions imposed by the regulations. So, students, these are the important topics which I had explained to you in this particular session. Let us see, let's go back and just let's see what all the things we have understood in this particular session. So e-governance means it is also called as the electronic governance, which will be dealing with the section 4 to 10A of IT Act of 2000. Then I said it provides legal recognition of electronic records and the electronic signature, and thereby it provides the legal recognition of the contracts which is being formed through the electronic means. And filing of any kind of form or application or any other document, creation, retention, preservation of records, issue or grant of any kind of license or permit, or the issue or the payment in the government officers and its agencies may be done through the means of electronic form. Then the government may authorize any of the services provider to set up or maintain and upgrade the computerized facilities and perform such other services as it may specify, which is been given through the notified by the official gazette for efficient delivery of services to the public through this electronic means. Then it says where any law provides documents, records of information should be retained for a specific period of time, then such documents or record or information which is been retained in the electronic form will also be covered if the information contained therein remains accessible and electronic record is retained in the format it was generated or sent or received, in the format which can be demonstrated or represents accurately. Then where any law provides for audit of documents, records of information, the related to that provisions will be applicable for audit of documents or the records or information possessed and maintained in electronic form. Then also if there are any law which is providing any rule that provides any rule, regulation, order or any bylaws, notifications or any other matter should be published in the official gazette, and then such kind of requirement shall be deemed to have been satisfied if the rule, regulation or any other order, bylaws, that notification is given in the official gazette or electronic gazette. Whatever the provisions we mentioned above, all that does not give any right to anybody or compel any ministry or the department of government to use the electronic means to accept, issue, create, retain and preserve any document or execute any monetary transactions. Now there are some e-governance applications which is already using the digital signatures, that is a machine mode project under the National E-Governance Plan, which is one of the first few e-governance projects which is coming under National E-Governance Plan, successfully implemented the digital signatures in that project. Then income tax filing, e-filing, then IRCTC, that is Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation, Direct General of Foreign Trade, RBI applications, National E-Governance Service Delivery, e-procurement, e-office, e-district applications, UP Assam. Now what is, who is the certifying authority? So it's a trusted body where central responsibility will be there in order to issue, revoke, renew and provide directions of digital certificates. And this certifying authority means is a person who has been granted a license to issue an electronic signature certificate under section 24. And this particular certifying authorities, it says under this, it contains details of provisions which is related to the appointment and powers of the controller and the certifying authorities. Now, who is the controller of certifying authority, CCA? It says under the IT Act provided that control of the certifying authorities to license and to regulate the working of certifying authorities, and the certifying authorities issue the digital signatures certificates for electronic authentication of users. And this particular CCA certifies that public keys of a CA using its own private key, which enables users in the cyberspace to verify that given certificate is issued by licensed certifying authorities. Now for this purpose, it will operate the root certifying authority of India. The CCA also maintains the national repository of digital certificates, which contains all the certificates issued by all the CAs in the country. So what are the functions of the controller? So I have told you, to exercise supervision over the activities of certifying authorities, certify public keys of certifying authorities. So all these important functions I have explained to you, students. See you, students, in next class. Thank you.